Hey guys, welcome back to our video Creatnprocess. Today we'll be working on underblending vector art design. We'll create alphabet in the form of tubes, we'll use pen tool to draw the alphabet in a single stroke line, then use replace spline to replace the blended object with the strokes, and also use 3D extrusion in Photoshop to create the perspective view. So let's begin our tutorial. First, bring out the rulers to set the guidelines. Set the first two guidelines for the two ends and the third one for the center. Duplicate the guides for the second and third row by leaving a gap. Now, using the pen tool with the stroke color black, we'll draw the alphabet in a single stroke. Create alphabet A using the pen tool. Just click on the endpoints to get a straight line. For alphabet B, press shift to get a straight line and click and drag to make the curves. We'll complete the design in a single stroke. Adjust the handles to maintain the flow. In the same way, we'll create out rest of the alphabets using basic shapes and pen tool. While creating alphabet E, we'll continue the stroke without breaking and create a middle line. After that, set the anchor point align with the stroke using direct selection tool. In the same way, create out alphabet F and G. We'll use two strokes to create alphabet H. Extend the strokes to create the division. Also create alphabet K using two strokes. Now complete creating all the other alphabets. Next, draw out a circle using ellipse tool. The size should be in proportion to the text. Bring it down and create a duplicate with the Alt pressed. Select body circle and go to Object, Blend, Make. This will create a blending object between two circles. To increase the number of steps, double click on the Blend tool. And under blend option panel, set the spacing to specified steps. Increase the value to around 41 and click OK. After that, set the stroke thickness to 0.25 points. This will create a nice blending with thin strokes. Now we'll duplicate this for a few number of times. Press the Alt key and with the mouse just click and drag to create the duplicate. With a shortcut command or control D, you can repeat the same steps and create out multiple duplicates. After that, select one of the blended object and the alphabet, then go to Object, Blend, Replace Spline. With this, the blended object will take the shape of the selected alphabet. We'll do this for all the text. Select each and every one of them and apply Replace Spline. For the alphabets with two strokes, apply them individually. Once you're done with all the alphabets, select all and increase the steps value 260. Delete the guidelines, arrange the alphabet individually and then duplicate it for once. Add a black background using rectangle tool, then arrange the font to front and change the color to white. Here we can see the density of the blended applied to each text is very large. So, select all the text and reduce the steps value to 210. Next, we'll use Photoshop to create 3D perspective design. So open a new Photoshop document. Drag and drop the whole design to Photoshop. Scale it up to fill up the canvas size. Now selecting the layer, go to 3D, new 3D extrusion from selected layer. This will add a new control to the smart object. Now we can rotate the image in 3D perspective view. We can rotate and move in XYZ position. So, we rotate Z axis to around 50 degrees, then Y axis to around 23 degrees, and rotate along the X axis to give inclination to the design. Use the arrows to move the object along the direction. We'll place the design to the center and bring it toward the frame to scale it up. From here, it depends on how you want your design to look on the frame. You can do all the adjustments with the position, rotation, and scale to get a proper composition. Next, we'll adjust the falling light direction. Click the white circular icon on the top. This will activate the light controls. You can click on the top sphere and drag to play around with the light direction. Let's give little shadow on the back side. Do the final adjustments such that your design fills up the whole canvas. Next, to add some contrast and highlights, add brightness and contrast adjustment layer. Here, we'll set a contrast value around 41 and brightness value to 16. This will enhance the look of the design. Now, you can see the alphabets are looking very clear and sharp. Next, we'll add a font for the design. Use the text tool and type out tube. Choose a proper font for the text. Give Source Sans Pro black font. Duplicate the text and type blending. Reduce the size to 12 points with the font Cerverec Lite. And give the spacing around 840. Duplicate the text one more time and type vector art. Reduce the spacing to 555. Draw out a black rounded rectangle and place it below the text. Scale it up and reduce the opacity to around 64%. Finally, we have completed designing blending tube vector art. We have understood the advanced use of Replace Spline option and also the practical use of 3D extrusion in your projects. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe this channel. Thank you.